once upon a time, just 2 years ago actually, I found myself just beside myself on the bed. And it was about this time of year. And it's something that I thought I had dealt with, right? Because we deal with it, right? We just kind of live, experience things, and move on. So what had happened is I didn't know why the days leading up to October 9th, I was getting irritable and cranky and becoming this monster. And then it hit me, and I just was catatonic, crying for days, because October 9th is my father's birthday, and he died in 1996. And at the tender age of 24, I had the privilege of being the only person available to identify him in a morgue. And I thought that I had already grieved. And so I realized that for the first time, I was finally allowing myself to feel grief. And I didn't want to fight it, because I'm thinking, okay, now some days have passed. It's now October 12th, and I've got kids that I'm homeschooling, six of them, right? No. I have a business that I started 2 years before, and what am I going to do? So I leaned into it. I leaned into feeling everything I felt for my father. He was a brilliant man. He was an attorney, had his own practice, and what was I really missing was his guidance right now that I had started my own business, you know? And I leaned into that, and I felt the love and the compassion, and I let the wisdom emerge, and I decided to use my emotions as a power source. So that's what I do now. I had what I call a body soul shift, and I wrote a chapter about that in the recent book that came out earlier this year with my co-author Oprah Winfrey and Melinda Gates. It's a book called America's Leading Ladies. So my chapter is about this body soul shift and finding yourself. And so now whereas in the beginning when I founded my business, I thought that I just help people to eat right and exercise, right? To work out around their day, I now understand that I help women to use their emotions as a power source by creating healthy barriers and boundaries so that they can be replenished and powerfully impact the world. So I just want to invite you, if you know someone who is numbing out in any forms of toxic behavior, you know, they work really hard, like maybe 10 extra hours every day in the office. Maybe they go to the gym way too often. Maybe they quietly just have a couple of extra glasses of wine, right? Nothing really obvious. They look like they've got it all together, right? I was the happy mom of six, homeschooling, started a business, nice smile on my face, always talking about sweet talk. So you may know this woman. Reach out to her and ask her